the Hindu presents a vision for India 2040. It's a youth debate, so it's not. It's for Indians who are much younger, but maybe you know, at the forefront of their careers when 2040 comes around. This is in honor of India's 75th Independence Day, which is of course in 2022, but in a sense, the celebrations have already begun. This is the year leading up to the 75th year of India's independence. And for each of us, that means something special. But it means much more for the next generation, for the generation that is really looking at their futures being formed by what they see today and what they think needs to be done to make things better, what needs to be righted, what wrongs affect them that need to be righted. The Hindu, of course, operates on a particular value of fairness, justice, and the idea that everyone must feel a safe space in order to put out their views and be able to say what they really feel and make it something that can be in a constructive atmosphere and make that something that's constructive. So we're especially delighted to engage with the young minds of our country on their vision for the future. And excerpts from the session will actually be presented to our readers through a curated article as well that we have by the editorial team. It will feature in the Future India edit of our 75th Independence Day special. That's on the 15th of August. Some of you might be wondering why you've been chosen, and you know how you got in touch with us through different social media networks. The preliminary round of the Hindu Vision for India 2040 Youth Debate was conducted completely, in fact, on social media. We wanted to engage really with those who are out there, who aren't necessarily only, you know, and especially in a year with COVID, the coronavirus pandemic, everything that your generation has had to deal with, in terms of resilience, in terms of just, you know, getting through your college, school, and getting to work in such a difficult year. So we connected with everyone on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, asked you to come forward and be thought leaders, share your views about the future of the country. So from all the entries, we shortlisted 17 participants for the final round, and we hope to hear your views. In the next hour or so, we are going to ask each of you to speak. You already know what you think, but we want you to put it out there and put it out there in 3 minutes. So there is no for and against. We call it a youth debate, but that's because it is from the spirit of inquiry and debate that we think we should go forward. This is not, the idea is not to counter somebody else's idea. So we're going to get to it straight away. Now to our youngest participant today. Om Kumar is 12 years old, but he has already racked up a whole series of honors. He's the winner of the Water Heroes contest organized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. And it's no surprise, he runs a website for water conservation as well. Om, tell us about your vision. Obviously, water conservation is a large part of that. You are just 12. So in 2040, you'll be probably just starting out in your career. Where do you see yourself? Where do you see India in 2040?
Yes, ma'am. Greeting to the August gathering and my wishes in advance for India's 75th Independence Day. I am Om Kumar, a 12-year-old boy from New Delhi, who shall be 32 years of age in the year 2040. As rightly said by our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, the future depends on what we do in the present. I do believe in the same. I also humbly state that I am a winner of the prestigious national level Water Heroes Share Your Stories contest March 2021. Organized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, Government of India. In the field of water conservation, I have developed a user-friendly website for the mission Save Water, Save Life. So, today, I will share my vision for India 2040 in the field of water conservation. Well, my vision is that every citizen of India must adopt and implement water conservation practices and become more conscious about the value of each drop of water. Every building in India should become 100% water positive. Here, we can take the example of Kempe Goda International Airport in Bengaluru, which replenishes more water than it consumes. Water is a very serious topic indeed, and we all know that the issues concerning water are going to be more critical in the years to come. The main reason of acute shortage of water is that many people of our country are not being as responsible as they should be. If everyone makes his or her contribution, whether at micro or macro level, India will never face any water issue. The average annual per capita water availability in the year 2001 was assessed as 1,816 cubic meters, and in the year 2011, it was 1,545 cubic meters. I was rather taken aback when I read somewhere that it may further reduce to 1,367 cubic meters per capita by the year 2031. So, let us start to work towards water conservation from today itself. I know my vision cannot be achieved in one day or two. However, it can surely be achieved by 2040. Yes, it can be achieved. Prithviyam Trini Ratnani Jalamannam Subhashitam. Arthat, Prithvi par Jal, Ann aur Suvachan, ye teen hi ratan hain. Thank you to the Hindu group for giving me this opportunity to express my opinion for the Vision 2040. Jai Hind.
Jal, Ann and Suvachan, very well put. Thanks so much, Om Kumar.